showing up. So like, what will you do to like increase that, and like, how we make it possible to have new ones if like people don't come sometimes to the old ones in terms of like money or time conflicts and things like that? Not just fun program. I'm saying, for example, like if Makuko from BCI needed more people to come to her program event, the program isn't just the fun stuff. Programs is every program because they'll collaborate with other board members. So I guess what I'm trying to say is, with your programs and with ones that other new members are already trying to have in place, how are you going to keep retention rate coming to all these events?
Oh, okay, I'll start first. So one thing I would want to implement in order to increase retention and like the attendance, I think we should have like some sort of incentive system. So I know Shep, they have like battle Shep points, and I know we have a similar system implemented in NSB. But like, if we consistently have those and like consistently have people coming out and showing that they're interested, I feel like they should be rewarded. So by coming out to events and always showing support and stuff, I feel like those people doing that should be rewarded through like conferences and other things like that.
Something that I would do is definitely discussing everything at GB meetings, because I know that was one of our issues this year, is that we kind of did a lot of things behind scenes. So if we involved GB a lot more, it would definitely make them want to come out more. And also doing incentives, but in like a different way. So I kind of guess like at each event, we could have the incentive for the person who brought the most people. So having like a sign-in sheet, so you sign in, who'd you come with those in the org, and that person would get like a little prize for bringing in the most amount of people.
So a big part of being a program chair is working with the e-board. So biggest thing, membership chair as well as communications chair to get the word out. So utilizing any sort of social media flyers, but as well as letting your general body know during general body meetings how or when the event is going to take place. That's really crucial. Incentives is always a great thing, but I think we can do more than just incentives. So possibly like just prizes, just more than just points. Essentially what I'm trying to say. So.
To increase membership retention, I would try to make sure our point system is more vocalized. Like, for example, in meetings worth this many points, and then have a live like Excel to see how many points you have, so you know if you need to be involved more or not. And if there's events that aren't working as well, I would just have a feedback survey after certain events to see if like we should continue this program or not, so we're not wasting our time.
All right, so many of you talked about incentives, especially with a point system. At least for this year, points was focused more with the membership chair. So for next year, how would you work with the membership chair to make sure that our point system is something that is both transparent and easily communicated to the general body?
So I guess planning ahead of time is definitely really crucial. I think that we should definitely start making a point system over the summer just so we know what exactly we want on it and what exactly would count for what points, how much, just so we have like an outline before going into school, because I feel like once we start, things are going to get really hectic, so it's better to start as soon as possible. So definitely having that layout as soon as possible would be really good. And also kind of what Sam said, making it transparent, so making sure that everyone knows that this is the amount of points you have, this is what you can get if you have X amount of point, and just making everything very transparent.
So I think utilizing the summer is a great aspect of what we can do. Just planning ahead of time, because once school starts, we're off and running. So I think also giving the general body access to especially specifically what their points are, maybe through a Google Docs or something of that form, will allow everyone to understand where they are and where we're headed. As well as, giving the general body ahead of time certain events throughout the month, throughout the next 2 months, will just let them understand this is where you can earn points and do it from that standpoint.
And like I said earlier, just to have the Google Doc with all the points, and also for like communications, when we publicize events, to have how much points they are worth to members.
Yeah, piggybacking off what everyone said, I would, like, over the summer, I would try to create a guideline, basically like a syllabus going in to the next school year. So, I mean, the guidelines are pretty set. I mean, if you forget over time, you can always refer back to the guideline, see what events we have planning to coming up, and seeing how much those events are worth point-wise. And then working with the membership chair, seeing what programs, like down the line after school has started, seeing what events a lot of members would be interested in doing, because I believe that would also increase the amount of attendance at our programs and stuff like that.
All right, so my next question is, it's kind of twofold. So give me one program, I mean, or you could list multiple if you have a lot of programs in mind, but could you give me like one program that you would have in mind for the next school year? And could you tell me like what steps you would take in planning it to like what goes into being a program chair for a certain program?
So one of the things that, like as part as the, as we mentioned, is to grow professionally. I would really like to see us to really coordinate with companies and visit them in the workplace. So one of the things I want to do is probably just have a day where we can go out, see different companies, just talk with them, network with them. How we plan it, first is to get funding. So we have to plan transportation, whether we're going to stay overnight or certain things like that. Working with our treasurer, working with the president, as well as the company, to just get an understanding of what we can do, the itinerary, and then go from there.
One of my goals for next year would be to increase our Nesby family bond. And I know after nationals, all of us are really close just because we spent so much time together. So I would like to have probably a family potluck, and planning into that would just be organizing where it would be, who would bring what, and for example, if you're on campus and can't bring food, just donating money so y'all can become closer as a chapter.
One event or program that I would want to have is beginning of the year, have like a little family cookout, so that way people coming back from the summer, we can all meet up like before our first board meeting, see how everyone's doing, check in with each other, and also it would be like a follow-up to like the first week when we have, like, everyone is tabling for their respective organizations. It could be like a follow-up before the first meeting, just so you're staying in touch with everyone that came out, all the new students, or even returning students that may not know a lot about Nesby, but definitely want to get involved, like reaching out to them and seeing that we're just one big happy family and trying to, you know, live up to the Nesby mission.
So I actually have two programs that I really would love to try to implement if I do get the position. So the first one is a Nesby meetup. So this would kind of bring together all the Nesby chapters within Penn State, because one of the things that we don't utilize are our members. Like, even though we are at Penn State Maine, there are other Penn State campuses that do have a Nesby chapter, and we don't have a chance to kind of like get to interact with them until one of the bigger travel events like FRC, Nationals, and all that. So I definitely want to create an event that allows us all to come together to just do something really fun at the very beginning of the semester, so we create those bonds early on. And then the second event is, it's more of an idea. I want Nesby to have kind of like a signature event that we do, like something similar to what like ASA, CSA does with like Touch of Africa and the experience. Like, I want Nesby to have something that we can call our own and that we can do in the previous year, so that people know that like we do a lot on the campus, like showcasing like engineers, bringing in like keynote speakers to speak, because that's also something that we don't do, is like utilizing our alumni and the professional side of things. I guess like implementing it would kind of just be like figuring out what our members would want to see in this event, so like definitely like including them a lot more with the planning itself.
Thank you, y'all. So the devil's in the details. It takes a lot to be able to see a program, but then to be able to break it down to delegate things to certain people takes a lot of effort as well. Candace has done a great job putting her own time and energy this past year, but you know, you have to be very, very organized to be able to get something big done. So what things do you do as a student or as a leader that keep you organized, and how do you plan to implement them when in your role as program chair?
I live by my live and breathe by my planner. I have everything mapped out. I currently take 18 credits, have a job, and involved in another, and I'm involved in a lot of other clubs. So I pretty much just make sure, like, at the beginning of the week, I map out everything I have to do when I want to do certain things, and I'll just continue to do that for the next
year. So I do a few things. One thing, I use a planner as well. I'll write down all my weekly assignments, my homework I have on. Also, a Google Calendar, set constant reminders for myself because, you know, people are like, oh, I got this to do, but, you know, we're all busy, so, you know, you can forget it. So, always having reminders and then accountability, like, always having, so, like, in my classes, I always have one person I try to work with because I don't know, like, to keep them in check and they're going to keep me in check. So, working with somebody, whether it be, like, a GB member or, like, someone on the e-board to just keep me accountable, and if I'm working on the team, work as a team to be accountable, so like we all are achieving our goals and making sure everyone else is achieving their goal.
I'm involved in Blueprint, Nesby. I'm on the fencing team, and I'm also double majoring, so staying organized is something that like I've had to develop because it's a lot. So like everyone said, using a planner, but I feel like when it comes to the actual program, making sure you plan things out accordingly and ahead of time is really important. So like if you know you want to do an event in the end of the semester, that means you need to start planning this event a couple months ahead, making sure that at that point you're writing down everything as possible, like as much as you can when it comes to planning. So what's going to go into the event, how long it is, then breaking it down within the time so you know that like you can get everything done or what actually needs to be done, and then making sure that when you actually go to execute everything that you do it in a timely manner so that you have the time to do anything if you need to make up for stuff that you forgot to do.
So going on the same lines, so I use a planner, make sure all my classes are in the morning so I get things done in the afternoon. But as far as this specific role is being very specific, planning way far ahead of time, 2 months, writing down everything you need, looking to other e-board members and collaborating with them to just make sure that everything's in order to take the next steps and take the next initiatives, as well as then going down to executing and then going to getting the resources that you need.
We have time for one more question.
Question is really simple. So as programs chair, one of the things that you're responsible for is Nesby Week. I just wanna like if you can like run through me real quick some like not specifics but like when would you do it? Do you have like one or two big thing programs in mind that you would do during Nesby Week? How you structure it? So my question was as programs chair, one of the things that you're responsible for is Nesby Week. So I was just wondering if you could like run me through really quickly how you would structure that, time frames, when you would hold Nesby Week, one or two signature events that you would do.
So I would try to run it towards the beginning of the semester. So like everyone is coming back and it's always good to always have a good start to the semester because that could dictate how things go for the semester. So I would like the first event I would have is definitely set up a table in the hub, like a tabling event, so people can come out and get to meet us, have a few giveaways, like have a board to show like how actively involved we are, and, like how the companies really respect the Penn State Nesby family. So just highlighting our presence on campus, and then I would end with like a gathering or a cookout or something food related, because you know everyone loves food, so and that's always a good way to bring people together. And it's always it would be a good end to the week and a good start to the weekend.
So I guess being on the e-board, I actually had a chance to work with Candace in organizing Nesby Week. And one thing that I would definitely improve on is making it towards the end of the first semester. I found that the second semester is packed full of a whole bunch of stuff from other orgs, and not to step on anyone's toes and kind of like to give us the chance to shine with our own week, I would definitely do it at the end of the first semester because in that time there's not too much going on, so like everything can be focused around Nesby. One or a few events that I would want to do is a panel and bringing in people who were in NSBE just to see kind of like what they've done and like how NSBE really helped them, as well as bringing in people in the professional world, because we want to get like advice from them as well. And definitely a cultural potluck, we were not able to do it, but like definitely involving other orgs, so like CSA, ASA, and getting that cultural aspect and having everyone from the different orgs bring in dishes so that we can all like kind of like grow culturally and just like experience different people's cultures.
So I have two time frames in mind. One's the week before the career fair, so that we can bring in keynote speakers to help us, to tell us what they're looking for and help us grow professionally. Another time frame is towards the end of the semester, a lot less is going on, so we can really shine and really grow culturally, as well as bringing keynote speakers, alumni, and just have certain fun activities to just grow, not only us as a chapter, but the Penn State chapters. So just utilizing those two different time frames.
The time frame I would choose would be probably during the first semester, around that time when it's kind of dry after like winter break, so therefore as many people can come as possible because not really when anyone's busy. And what I would want to do is have a ton of mini events throughout the week, and you receive like raffle tickets or something for a big event on like the last week on Friday, so that way there's involvement throughout the whole week and not just certain events that have food or the ones that sound fun.
Thank you. We have membership.